Hey guys, it's Becky with Design Bundles, and I'm here today to tell you all about setting up print and cut stickers with your Silhouette Cameo. Now, we've done this for Cricut already, so if you're a Cricut subscriber, then make sure you jump over and check out that video. But I heard your pleas, and you want to learn more about print and cut with your Silhouette Cameo, and here we are. So we're going to cover everything from setting up the file to actually performing a print and cut with our Silhouette Cameo. So let's go ahead and get started, guys.
Okay, so to start with, I wanted to find some fun inspirational stickers, and I found those. I just searched for inspirational stickers at designbundles.net, and I really like this set that I found here, and it must be pretty popular because it was the very first listing that popped up. So pretty excited about that. I'm just going to add to cart and check out. But what I wanted to say too, and this isn't like make or break, but you do want to come down and check out the file types and make sure that you're getting either a PNG or a JPEG. I do prefer a PNG, but we can make do with JPEG too. So we'll just go ahead and check out. I'm going to download my files. Now remember, they download as a zipped file, so we do want to extract those. I'm on a PC, so you might be a little bit different on a Mac. I'm just going to hit extract all. Now it's going to throw those into my downloads folder, so we will be able to open them straight from Silhouette Studio. So let's go ahead and hop over there. Now in Silhouette Studio, the very first thing that you want to do is go ahead and set up your paper for printing. Okay, so I chose letter size because that is the type of material, the size of material that I'm using, and I turned on my 12 by 12 cutting mat. Okay, so another thing I want to do is make sure that I have my print border and my cut border turned on. Now my print border is a little skewed, and if it doesn't line up with what you're expecting, what you want to do is go to File and Print, and make sure that you've selected the printer that you want to use. I am going to use my Brother printer right here, so I'm going to hit Apply and Cancel, and then you'll notice it fixed my print border so that it fits the same 8.5 by 11 sheet of paper that I have. So let's go ahead and bring in the files that we want to work with. I'm going to go to File and Merge. That way it'll open these files that I'm using. Let me see, there we go, Girl Power. It will open these in the same window that I've already selected. So I will do PNG. Okay, so what I want to show you is that, number one, if I click over to Send, and I turn on my cut lines, it is going to cut this rectangle. Okay, so keep that in mind, and that's what I'm gonna walk you through doing today, is how to isolate these and then how to modify your settings here in Silhouette Studio to be able to cut the outline of these images. Okay, now luckily these already come with the little outline, but don't worry, we'll talk a little bit about that too and how to make your own. So I'm gonna zoom in here. And what I want to do, now you can do this multiple ways. You can use the knife tool, or you can crop these down individually. And what I'm going to do is use my draw rectangle here. And the first thing that I will do is zoom back out, and I want to set up one of each of these stickers. Okay, so maybe this will be a little bit easier. I'm going to turn on a cut line for that rectangle. So let's take a look at these. So there's my rectangle, and you can see that I'm trying to overlap and yet not cut off any of the parts for those stickers. All right, so then what I'm going to do is I've selected both of these. I'm going to go to my Modify panel and choose Crop. And that just gives me one of each of these, right? So now I can use my knife tool. And you see how I have my crosshairs turned on? Now crosshairs are a designer edition feature, but they're very useful, and they're in your page setup menu under your grid settings. So if you open your grid settings, here are your crosshairs. And the reason I'm pointing that out is you can see that I can align my crosshair in between those stickers, hold down my shift key, hold down my mouse key, and it will draw a straight line. So I'm using my crosshairs to determine where I'm going to cut so that I don't accidentally cut one of these stickers in half. Okay. Now, let me pause real quick. I know that we've gone over a lot in a fairly short amount of time. Some stickers and clip art, you will not have to do this to. If they come in as individual PNG files, then by all means use them individually. You will not have to split them up. But these were made to be planner stickers, so I do have to split them up because they were on one PNG file. Okay, so I'm going to turn off these lines because they're not useful for us right now. And let's still just take a look. I just want to continue to show you. It would still only cut squares, and squares is not what I want. I want them to be super cute and to cut a contour cut around my stickers. Okay, so zoom out just a little bit. I'm going to use my trace panel. And this is where, you kind of get a buildup of skills. You know, first you learn how to import PNGs. You also learn how to trace. You learn how to use your modify panel to crop things down. So don't feel like if you're a brand new beginner, don't feel like these are things that you should know. All you need to do is pause the video, back up a couple steps, and you can still follow along. Okay, but I just wanted to understand that, you know, if you're new to us and you're getting intimidated by all the things you have to do in Silhouette Studio, don't be intimidated, but just understand that it is a slow buildup of things, and that's what we're here for. We're here to walk you through step by step. So pause, take some notes, rewind, whatever you need to do. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is just do the regular trace, and let me show you. If I select my trace area, then I can dial down my scale and increase until it picks up all of my design. And then I can hit trace. And that will give me the offset around this design. I'm going to stick with the normal trace, which is better for you guys anyway, because that means that you can actually also trace all of these at the same time. So let's do that. So let's get rid of this first one that we did. So I'm going to use select trace area, select all of these. Okay, I'm still going to dial down my scale, and I'm going to increase my threshold all the way up and hit trace. There is something else that you need to do. It's super easy to trace in bulk like that, but you want to come in here and release your compound path. That's how you're going to break them up individually. All right, so let's also talk back on the modify panel. What I'm going to do is I'm going to select these. And when I say these, I'm selecting the clip art and the outline that we just created using the trace. Okay, clip art, outline. I've not moved them, they're still lined up. I'm gonna select those and I'm gonna choose crop. And I'm gonna continue to do that for each of these stickers. And this will make more sense in a moment, okay? Because what happens is Silhouette Studio has a feature for setting up a print bleed, but it's not going to do that if you had not cropped these down, because it would pick up that the outside of your design was that white box, okay? So that'll make more sense, but just understand that after you create your offset to do your print and cut, then you want to go ahead and crop that down so that it's the size that it needs to be. And here's another example, just check back in. See, now it will cut out around each individual sticker. Also, before I forget again, make sure on your page setup panel where we designated the size of our paper and our mat, make sure you turn on print bleed. This is really important for doing the print and cut with Silhouette Studio, and this is the reason why it was important for us to crop down those images. So definitely make sure it's turned on before you print, and that will hopefully take care of the majority of your alignment issues. Because what it does is it picks up the colors from your clip art and it creates a small border matching those colors, so that if the alignment is a little bit off, you don't end up with that awkward white border around your sticker. Now let's talk about something else. We're going to talk about your registration box, registration marks. And I'm going to turn on type 1 because I have a cameo. Now this is, remember, our print border is the gray line. Now you see our cut border. It moved in a little bit. That's because you cannot cut where your registration marks are going to print. So now you want to move these down. And you can also size these, determine what size you want them to be. I'm going to make them a little bigger. I want them to be decent size stickers. I'm going to go with 2 inches. That's probably because I'm not going to put these in my planner. I just want them for fun. I mean, who doesn't need fun motivational stickers in their life? That's all I'm saying. So most of them were close to 2 inches anyway. And then what I'm going to do, because I have this whole sheet to fill up, I'm going to also do them in 3 inches. Or I guess maybe as many as I can in 3 inches. Now I know you saw me do that quick duplicate, and that is a shortcut that you learn with Silhouette Studio, and it is control and a directional arrow on your keyboard. Now, we have a video on our top favorite Silhouette Studio shortcuts, and that's where I go over quick things like that. So make sure you check that out. It's a really cool video. I mean, of course, I think it's cool, right? Let's see. How many of these can I fit on here? Don't be afraid to move these around. You just want to make sure that you don't get anything in that gray area or outside of the red line. Okay, so I just couldn't make it work. Eventually, I admitted defeat and just made them a little smaller. This is also where your nesting tool can come into play. And of course, we have a video on the nesting tool as well. So make sure you check out that video, because then you don't have to do all this by hand. Okay, ladies, that's probably as good as it's gonna get. So we're just gonna make do. There we go. And make sure that none of your cut lines overlap. And we are going to print this. So we will go to File and Print, and then select the printer that we want to print to. Now remember, we already chose when we were setting up that print border. So it should already be selected. So just go ahead and load the material in your machine and print it out. After printing, we will go ahead and reconvene over on our workspace so that we can take a look at doing this as a print and cut on your Silhouette Cameo.
Okay, so I have our printed sheet with the registration marks, and I have a cutting mat for my Silhouette Cameo. I'm going to remove this protective layer. Now this is a brand new mat, so it's super sticky, so you have to be careful, and I'm just not going to push down a whole lot. Now, what you can also do if you have a brand new cutting mat is take a towel or a t-shirt and get some of that sticky off, but I'll be honest with you, I'm not a fan of doing that, so I'm just going to power through. I'm going to line up my mat with each roller here on the side and load. Now, I am cutting on the cardstock setting because I want to cut completely through this. I want these to be individual stickers, but if you wanted stickers that were just kiss cut through the front and not cut all the way through on the back, then you would need to adjust your cut settings. I've heard that washi tape cut settings work well, but I haven't tried those out myself. So now I'm going to hit send, and it should pick up, or at least attempt to pick up, my registration marks. There we go. So we got a really good cut that time. So I'm going to unload, and I can proceed to peel this from the back. Now remember, like I said, this is a very sticky mat, so it's probably going to take me a minute. And a lot of people, myself included, when I usually remember, say to peel the mat from the paper instead. And that should keep your paper from curling up. Okay, so I still got a little bit of curl there on the end, but that's not a big deal. So now I should be able to just pull these from the back. It looks like it didn't get a super clean cut. So what I would recommend if you're wanting to cut all the way through the back is to
up your force. The force is normally on a 20, but it looks like it needs to be a little bit more. But that's okay because I still got a really good cut on the actual sticker part, which is more important anyway. There we go. So now I can just as easily take my scissors and go around. I'm not saying cut around here, but I can cut around just squares around my stickers to take care of that. So this is my sticker. I cut it on a nice glossy paper, and I'm overall very happy with my print and cut experience. And next time I know that I just need to cut it a little deeper. So just for kicks and giggles, I'm going to throw these on this cute little journal that I have, and they are going to be absolutely perfect. So I'm just going to create like a little collage. Let's see. Be your own hero, of course. All right, so that's a perfect example of just some really cute stickers that you can do. And hey, I'm in love.
Well, print and cut was pretty easy. Now, I'm not saying that people don't have complications with print and cut. It is one of those features that you either love it or you hate it, you know? So definitely don't give up. Keep trying. There are a few things that you can do to, you know, really get in there with your registration marks, get them recognized, maybe recognize them manually. So, you know, definitely some troubleshooting can go on to make sure that you get the best out of your print and cut experience. So, all right, guys. Well, of course, if you have any questions or comments, please feel free to leave them below. We do always come back in and check with you guys. And if you haven't already, make sure you subscribe to the channel because we do have a lot more fun videos for you right around the corner. I really appreciate you watching today, and we will see you next time.